just believing the Bible ain't true. The Bible's a bunch of fairy tales. I don't believe any of that stories. Well, let me show you some proof. Boom! That's... All this talk about Mount Ararat, you know, we found Noah's Ark. He was in modern-day Turkey. I seen that Kirk Hammer documentary. I'll tell you where it is. Frickin' Williamsport, wherever I'm in somewhere in Kentucky. The irony of Noah's Ark, right next door, no water entry. Hey, actually, this comes to life in the summertime. They actually have real drowning people in here, like screaming. It's pretty cool. It's hilarious, actually. Look at how aerodynamic this ark is. Noah must have had a lot of sandpaper. I got some questions. One day, hold on, we got a 2-day pass, 7-day unlimited pass, annual pass? Who's got a season pass to Noah's Ark? Oh, the Ark encounter, it's so realistic, it's built to the actual descriptions of the Bible. It's just, oh really? Did the animals have to go through this photo booth before they went inside? I don't think so. That was pretty cool. I don't know if you guys knew this, but right before they built the Ark, you know, the flood was coming, and then the building inspector was like, hey, wait, are you all up to fire code? And then they had to delay it a little bit, because they're like, we don't know. You get it. Steph Carswell, ladies and gentlemen, makes a great point. What'd you say? I talked to her agent. She don't want to be in the story. Listen, I don't know about all this red, yellow, black, and white talk, but if you're touring Noah's Ark in the middle of Kentucky in 2018, I can tell you firsthand, it's all white people. It was pretty cool of Noah to plan ahead, and like even like they wanted all the animals, even the animals with disabilities were allowed in the... Okay, just in case, if they didn't... I'm just saying if they couldn't walk... Okay, sorry. Actually, the most ironic thing on this entire arc... Severe storm shelter. Yeah, there's a storm. I'm pretty sure there's a storm coming. I'm pretty sure. Look at this boat. This thing is huge. This is where they kept all the animals. This is the room where Jack painted that portrait of Rose. Come on, guys. Oops, sorry, sir. It's rated R. You should not know that reference. I wasn't lying. Sorry, I always think about that song when I think about Noah's Ark, the Rihanna song. That's how we convinced my mom we could listen to Rihanna when we were growing up. Because we're like, Mom, she's Christian. She's talking about, no. She talks about Noah's Ark in her songs. Like, okay, kids, we trust you. I think from now on, when anyone asks me, hey, John, what's your favorite Bible verse? This is what I'm going to say. And everyone died except the 8 people in the ark. Wow, of all the verses to put on the wall, this... Wow. Okay, all the haters out there, like, John, the ark story's a fairy tale. John, the ark story's isn't true. I got a question. What did the animals eat that whole time? Easy. Boom. Goodness. It's like a Christian homeschool make-a-wish or something. My goodness, this place is amazing. Sometimes if a black guy, that was the first. Sometimes you're looking around and you're like, is this guy part of the exhibit or is this guy like an actual visitor? Noah! Hey! Okay, sorry guys. Hey, we're in the gift shop. Oh, what's up, dude? Okay, sorry. We're in the gift shop. I just got one quick question. Excuse me, ma'am. Yeah, hi. What's this? Yeah, I just don't understand. What's this take? Yeah, what does this mean? They do this like so realistic. Like right when you leave, they're like, it's gonna be the ice age, and they put this like snow from. It's just crazy out here. The special effects they got was wild. I think I give this place an A+ rating. Like, if you believe the Ark story is true or no, it's still cool to see. Like, I went to like the Civil War Museum a while back, and like obviously that's not like a real story, but it's still cool to see like how they think. You know? I'm just saying, believe whatever you want to believe. But if you had a choice, you want to go to the Creation Museum or the Evolution Museum? Which one would you go to? I'm saying, like, boom, you know, God creates man, sun, heavens, earth, evolution, just boring. You're just sitting there, black is horrible.